दिल्ली में 2000 से भी ज़्यादा लोगों की जान बचाने के लिए प्लाज्मा दिया जा चुका है और मैं तो खुद प्लाज्मा से मेरी जान बची।
इन द फर्स्ट फ्यू मंथ्स ऑफ आवर कोविड एक्सपीरियंस देयर वाज अ लॉट ऑफ हाइप एंड होप अबाउट प्लाज्मा थेरेपी इन द क्योर ऑफ कोविड। हाउएवर इट डिड नॉट स्टैंड द स्क्रूटनी ऑफ साइंटिफिक स्टडीज एंड इट्स नो लॉन्गर एन अप्रूव्ड थेरेपी फॉर कोविड। It has created unrealistic expectations in the minds of patients and their families who sometimes demand plasma therapy as an option for their near and dear ones.
We really need to know the nuances and what is the evidence base behind these things. So there should be references and there should be something which we call evidence profiles and also the understanding of the evidence to decision framework, so that what things were considered when the research evidence were translated to recommendations.
Plasma is a very, very precious commodity and should not be used except when absolutely indicated. There is also some indication that indiscriminate plasma therapy could actually help the mutant strains grow and escape the other therapies that are useful.
If you look at the AIIMS ICMR guideline, which is the April 2021 version, which is the revised one, we see that it calls for an off-label use. Off-label by its very definition means it's unapproved. So we really don't know what that guideline and that terminology means.
Plasma therapy is having people who have recovered, and after their recovery, 14 days after they're negative, willing to give their blood from which the plasma is taken. Also, the blood that they give has to have good amount of antibodies. So there are certain studies which are coming from India which suggest a number of people who are recovering are not having that good amount of antibodies.